大家好 I'm Nathan Rich, aka 火锅大王 I just happened to see this. Somebody named Johnny Harris had made a video called Why is China so damn big? So let's take a look at this guy's video. I've never heard of him before. I've never watched a single one of his videos ever. I had no idea who this person is. This is the first and only video I've ever seen. So without further ado, let's take a look.
Every country on this planet has a story about its founding, but China's story is different.
China's not different, at least not in any way that it should be treated differently. I'm not saying that this is him, but I've noticed that a lot of people who are like a fascist or on the right or anti-China or in a cult that is against communism or whatever it is, they often start by trying to explain why China's different than everywhere else. It's a special case, but not in a good way.So I'm not saying he's doing that. We don't know. Let's take a look.
China's story is a new story.
China's story is not at all a new story. China's story is so mind-bogglingly long that I have to focus on just a few hundred years for my studying because there's so much of it that it just would encompass my entire life forever to try to research even half of it. So this is a very bizarre thing to say 30 seconds into the video thatChina's history is new. I actually had to replay this to make sure that that's what he said. No, it's not new at all. It's the opposite of new. In fact, it's one of the oldest stories on Earth.
It's a story that is being used as a weapon to subjugate millions of people.
Such a weird way to start a video. It's a story that's being used to subjugate millions of people. Well, look, guy, I really wish we could live without governments. I do.I wish that this world would allow for countries, if there even was such a thing, without governments. But this world doesn't allow for that. So we need governments, and part of what all governments do is subjugate people. Sorry, that's every government. If you don't understand that or you're in denial about that, sorry, that's not my problem, right? That's just the reality that we're in. So far, all you've said is China is new, which is really weird, andIt's different and it's subjugating people, as if that's saying something.
To eliminate ancient cultures.
I'm not sure if he's been to China or not, but eliminating ancient cultures is a kind of a weird thing to say about one of the most ancient cultures, because when you come here, what you find is ancient cultures of all varieties that all together form this wonderful, crazy experience called the Chinese culture. So I guess I'm gonna have to see what he's talking about.
To expand China's borders farther than they've ever pushed before.
He's just said that China's looking to expand its borders further than they've ever been before, but what he was showing is Hong Kong, Taiwan, and the South China Sea. Some parts of the South China Sea are in dispute with other countries, but those are two-sided disputes. That's not China's fault, that's half China's fault and half the other countries, or however many countries they are. It's divided equally. Right? This is an international norm. This happens all the time. United States has border disputes. So, very weird, right off the bat.
It's a founding myth that can't be challenged within China.
So he's now saying that the founding myth can't be challenged in China. The founding myth about China is about the Xia dynasty. Chinese scholars have debates about if this ancient dynasty really existed or not. I don't really understand what he's talking about, that people can't debate it. This is debated all the time. In fact, the people who debate it are Chinese. It's not like there's people in America wondering if the Xia dynasty was real or not.
It has been so heavily peddled and thoroughly implanted into the Chinese psyche that most people believe that China actually looks like this.
What? No, they don't. This guy's making a video about China, so you would think that he knows something about it. I'm in China now. If I were to go outside and interview 25 people, 100 people, show them this picture and say, do you think that this is what China looks like? Zero of them would say yes. This is not what any Chinese people think China looks like. And the weird thing is, all you had to do to know this is just open up a Chinese website. Here, we'll do it right now. We'll do it together. China map.You'll notice there's something different about this map than the map that he showed. This map includes Taiwan. It includes the South China Sea, as you can see with these dashes. This is what Chinese people think China looks like. So when we look at the map that you're showing us, this is not what Chinese people think China looks like. So you're completely wrong.
That China actually looks like this, and that it has always looked like this.
I've been debunking people for, I guess, years now, and this thing that he just said is one of the stupidest things I've ever heard anyone say about China. I mean, just listen to what he said one more time.
And that it has always looked like this.
No one in China thinks that. Zero people in China think that China's borders, first of all, even look like this. But even if they did think that it looked like this, none of them think that it always looked like this. To say that is so revealing. It just means that, first of all, you don't do any actual validation of the research that you're doing, but it also means you're completely unaware of actual Chinese people and how they think about things and what knowledge they're exposed to, anything. You just have no idea what you're talking about. So this statement here is making me feel like your research is done by skimming Wikipedia or maybe watching other YouTube videos. I mean, this statement right here is so stupid that I actually can't believe that somebody edited this and allowed you to say it in the final version. That's shocking to me. You need to have a word with your editor about that one.
But China doesn't look like this. China actually looks a lot more like this.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't look like that. Actually, it looks more like the first one, which is also wrong, but it specifically doesn't look like this. I mean, I don't even know why I have to say this. It should be obvious to everyone watching this video that this is complete bullshit, but I mean, if it's not obvious to you why this is bullshit, then I guess that's why I'm here, to reverse the brain trauma that watching his video will do to you. So let me just explain to those of you out there who aren't total map nerds, what he's doing is he's taking his wrong version of the current China borders, and he's trying to wow you by showing you some old maps that show this other weird shaped thing as China. And then I guess he's gonna basically say that that's the real China and the rest of these areas aren't China. I've seen this narrative being pushed by English teachers and by other kind of far right types that really froth at the mouth to kind of go after Chinese people. I don't know why this guy's going after China. We don't know that he is necessarily. He could just be mentally deficient. We don't know. That's possible. But that's one thing that it tells me, is that he is aligned with this far right element that is very dishonest and deceptive. The other thing that it tells me that's very interesting is that he lacks any knowledge at all in Chinese history at all by looking at this. And I can tell you why. It's not for the reason that you think. It's because if he had knowledge of Chinese history, it would have meant that he would have had to research it. And when you research Chinese history, something that happens is you get introduced to this idea. And then a fork comes where either you can continue to research it or you can run away and feel like you've got a gotcha on China. The reality is, this map doesn't mean what they think it means at all. And I'm gonna prove it to you right now. The map that he's showing you is from this Wikipedia map, which is showing China separated from the autonomous regions. This map that you have here is actually an expansion of older maps like this. So this old concept that China is different than the rest of China, that people who don't understand history get very confused about, come from maps like this. And you'll see that this type of map is often used by revisionists to try to redefine modern China as just the eastern part of China. Interesting to note here, other than the fact that obviously Taiwan is right here, part of China, part of the same China that everybody means when they say China, there it is. But other than that, the interesting thing to note here is that China just seems to end here along this path. And this is what people will use as evidence that, like, oh, back then, this is what China really was. And see, this says Tibet. That's just simply not part of China. So clearly then, this type of map means that the gray is China and the yellow isn't China. This is what very stupid or disingenuous people say. The problem with that is it's totally incorrect. They always seem to ignore this part. This is a later map, 1944. This is just a random example. This is American. China proper, Xinjiang, Tibet, Mongolia, Manchuria. You'll notice that all of these things are outlined as being China, and yet there's these little borders here. That's because China proper was the heart of the empire, and the outside territories here were still part of China. They're still part of the empire. They're just not the core part of it. Now, something that they never want you to know about, don't look this up, guys, is that while there are maps like this that clearly, according to them, show China as only one half or one third or whatever of what China is today, there's also maps that look like this. Oh, what do you know? It's the rest of China. So this is Tibet, Mongolia, and Manchuria. And yet what it says across this is Chinese Empire. So this is the exterior of the mainland part of the Chinese Empire during the Qing Dynasty. When you show only part of China and you say that this is the real China, it tells me that you are totally unaware of all these other things, or you are aware of them and you're trying to push some kind of weird anti-Chinese agenda, because it's completely, obviously, factually inaccurate. It's wrong. This is a really weird theory, to be honest with you. I've never quite heard this one before.